275 years ago, a community of Christians called a pastor and covenanted to love God and to love their neighbors. 275 years ago, the community of the First Congregational Church, United Church of Christ, Bristol, Connecticut, was formed. Moving forward in faith, we continue to be a community that welcomes all, nurtures all, and changes the world with Christ's love.
In God's spirit of unconditional love, I welcome you to worship with the First Congregational Church in Bristol, Connecticut, an open and affirming congregation of the United Church of Christ on this New Year's Day and Communion Sunday. My name is the Reverend Kristen Kleiman. Please call me Kristen. Whether you are a longtime attender or this is your first service, whether you're worshiping live or later, whether you are in the sanctuary or online, you belong to God. And you belong to this Christian community. There are so many wonderful people to thank for sharing their incredible gifts so that our Advent, Christmas Eve, and Christmas Day services brightly shared the good news of God's love. And I want to thank everyone who donated poinsettias, who shared music, who helped usher, move furniture, set up, clean up. There was a lot of stuff, a lot of moving parts involved. And so I'm very, very thankful. Our 275th collection continues in January with diapers, and we can imagine that is much a needed item always. And everything that we've collected throughout this anniversary year has been shared with our ministry partners in Bristol. Next Sunday, January 8th, is Star Gift Sunday, which many of us look forward to with anticipation all year long. For those who have never participated in Star Gift Sunday, you are invited to be spirit-led in choosing a paper star and then let that star guide you throughout 2023. So I know that many people look forward to choosing their new stars, and thanks to Sandy, they've already been cut and they are ready for next week. I look forward to hearing the stories of how you were guided by your star in 2022. So if you haven't paid a lot of attention to your star lately, I invite you to dig it out. And to think about how God has been leading you with that star word. And if you are not going to be in person for worship next Sunday and you would like a star mailed to you, please contact the church office. For those worshiping online, I look forward to interacting with you through the comment section on Facebook. You can share prayers there right now, or you can contact me throughout the week. There are quite a few activities for youth coming up. Youth choir for grades 2nd through 8th will be in the sanctuary today at 11:15. This Saturday at 1 p.m. in the dining room will be the first official meeting of Cub Scout Pack 6. And next Tuesday, January 10th, or a week from Tuesday, January 10th from 6:30 to 7:30 will be the first meeting of Kids Club, an opportunity for children preschool and older to gather for fun, music, and Christian community. And a final invitation for worship today, if you didn't already, there are bells here on the side table, and I invite you to ring your bells in the second, the first, second, and fourth hymns. I didn't warn Bill, but during What Child Is This, which is a little bit quieter, it's also the communion hymn. So you can ring your bell, but it doesn't really lend itself to that, and perhaps you might be better served preparing your communion for communion. And so those of you who are at home, I hope that you will find a bell and that you will ring along with us and ring in this new year. So I invite all of us into a time of centering, a time to connect with God and feel God's presence. I woke up at like 3:30 this morning because I did not see the ball drop last night. I don't know about you. But I woke up at 3:30 and the thought in my heart was, thank you, God, for this new year. So let us center ourselves in that thanksgiving for this new year. Please join me in taking three deep, slow breaths, breathing in God's love, breathing in God's peace, breathing in God's joy. please join me in the call to worship as we light the Christ candle. On this New Year's Day, we rejoice. We rejoice with bells and songs of praise. We gather around the manger and give thanks for the Christ child, singing. Forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory forever. Comes from the Gospel of Luke, the second chapter, verses 21 through 38. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child, and he was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. When the time came for their purification, according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. And as it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of two turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for the glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband for 7 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped there with fasting and prayer night and day. At that moment she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. invite you to greet this new year by greeting one another with the peace and love of Jesus Christ. The peace and love of Jesus be with you always. To be seated. There's a lot of bell ringing then. I hope the, you know, the last hymn will have a lot of bell ringing. There is a lot of new in our lives right now. Today is the first day of a new year. Last week there were lots of new gifts given and received. And this is not a new show, but I was thinking about new, and I was thinking about this game show currently on TV, based on a classic, which is their way of saying old, right? Classic game show. Both of them are called Let's Make a Deal. Do you know Let's Make a Deal? Yes? Okay. So Let's Make a Deal. And while the prizes in the games have been updated to the new version, some things are still the same. Like, they will often say to a contestant something like this: "You have just won this wonderful new thing. Do you want to keep it, or do you want to trade it for what's in the box?" I hope you can see the box. So how many of you would want to keep this cuddly teddy bear? Yeah? Or how many of you would trade it for the surprise in the box? Ooh, that's a lot. Lots of you curious about what's in the box. For those of you who are online, I want to know, are you keeping the teddy bear or are you going for the surprise in the box? So we had a lot of hands for the box. So, because you want to know what's in the box, right? Let's see if I can get it open easily. It's a very fancy box. Now, for those of you who know Let's Make a Deal, you might call this a zonk, because it doesn't look like much of a gift, does it? It looks kind of mangy and old. I know, that's the word that my family members use for it. However, this is one of my most prized possessions. It is the Winnie the Pooh my parents gave me for Christmas when I was 3 years old. And this teddy bear is very well traveled and much, much beloved. We'll put him back gently. I felt bad to even put him in the box this morning. Sometimes new is better than old, and sometimes old is better than new. And sometimes they are both important, both connected, both a part of God's plan. In our Bible story today, we heard about Jesus being brought to the temple in Jerusalem to be blessed, as was the custom with all firstborn sons. This story is about a new baby. And this story is also about two wise elders, Simeon and Anna. The Bible especially wants us to know how old Anna was, right? She was of a great age, having lived with her husband for 7 years after her marriage, and then as a widow to the age of 84. Now, this was a time period when we thought 84 was a great age. Now we just think it's a great age, right? It's great to be 84. So, but our Bible story today, new is not better than old. Old is not better than new. They are a part of one another. They are connected. God's people needed these wise elders. God's people needed Anna and Simeon to remind them of God's promise of old. Promises the prophets spoke hundreds and hundreds of years before, that a savior was coming, a Messiah. A child would be born for them, and he would rule with justice and with mercy. This was God's promise of old, a promise generations and generations of God's people have been waiting for. It was an important promise. It's still an important promise, one that we should hold at the center of our lives, that God loves us so much that God wants to save us from unkindness, brokenness, and injustice. Sometimes, though, we can get stuck in the old. We can hear something so many times that we just don't hear it anymore, that it doesn't touch our hearts and change our lives. It's just words. And then we might miss the new ways God is fulfilling this promise of old. Anna and Simeon help God's people see the new. These wise elders help God's people see that God's promise of old was being fulfilled in a new way through Jesus, through this newborn child. As we begin this new year, we too are called to remember God's promises of old. We too are called to remember God's promises of justice and mercy, God's promises of peace and love. We are called to hold these promises of old at the center of our lives. They are not just words that people of faith have spoken for generations and generations. They are real promises made to us, real promises meant to change our lives and the world. As we journey into the new year, into this new world, into this new life, we hold on. Not to the old ways of being the church, not to old understandings of what it means to be a Christian. We hold on to God and God's promises. We hold on to God's ways of peace, love, justice, and compassion. And we open our eyes to the new ways God is fulfilling those promises in our lives, We open our hearts to the new ways God, to the new ways we can love God and love our neighbors. We open our minds to the new ways we can help our neighbors love God and know that they are loved by God. As we begin this new year, we hold on to God's promises of old, and we open ourselves to the new ways God can fulfill those promises through us. So I was sitting last night with my Christian planner journal, and it has some pages in the beginning about what are my goals for the year. And sometimes we think about, like, drink more water, eat more fruits and vegetables, right, exercise more. But of course, being a Christian planner, how do I intend to be with God more in this new year? So I invite you to start your first day with a very good first step. So let us be in a time of just having ourselves be really open to God and asking how God is leading us into the new. Let us be in a time of listening and discernment. Gracious Lord, we thank you for your faithful promises to each one of us, and we pray that, like with the Christ child, we might be created new to share your good news with all the world. We pray in his name, amen. I invite you now into a time of prayer where we can share together our joys as well as our concerns. And it was a joyous holiday week and also a sad holiday week, and so I lift up prayers for the Liberto and Griffin families as you grieve Bill's passing this past week and as we celebrate his glorious life on earth and his glorious life in heaven at this difficult time for you all. Other prayers people would like to share?
I'd like to ask prayers for my niece Katie, who will be facing some challenges in the new year.
So we pray healing prayers for Katie.
First for my mother, she fell and broke her wrist on the 23rd. And spent the day in her emergency room due to her Christmas Eve. And she just had to put down her dog, Snooper, after 12 years.
Oh. We pray for Doug's mom, who walked into Christmas with a broken wrist and then also is grieving the loss of her dog. It's very difficult. I'd ask you to pray for my child, wherever he is. You know how sometimes you hit the corner of the wall with your toe, and so I don't know if it's dislocated or broken, because I've blessedly never done either of those things. So pray for healing for him. We pray for Joe as he grieves the loss of his brother Scott, and for your family another loss.
Pray for my son's friend Liz, who lost her father the day after Christmas.
For Liz, who is also grieving.
Pray for my mom, who is going into another type of Christmas
surgery. See, she didn't want to tell us that.
I forgot.
Okay, that's a good one. We pray for Sharon, who is anticipating surgery. I was praying a lot for our police departments all over the world last last night, as New Year's Eve can be kind of a crazy time, and so we continue to pray for our Bristol Police Department, and as we pray for all of those who are currently on hospice and for all the families who are grieving losses, I sometimes feel like we get past Christmas and we experience a lot of loss throughout the month of January. I also want to lift up healing prayers, as we said, for Katie, for Kathy D., for Donna K., for Dave, Lisa and her husband, Lisa A., Michael W., Michael C., Chris C., Bob, Joe, Pam, Debbie, and Becky, and there are others. And there are a lot of birthdays that happened between the fourth Sunday of Advent and today. So I want to say a belated happy birthday to Steve T. and Beth T., no relation to each other. For Dave, who celebrated on the 21st, Friday is the 30th, right? And Roger celebrated his birthday. Matthew G. and Kaylee B. will have their birthdays tomorrow on January 2nd. A lot of birthdays on January 3rd. Lisa D., Tia, and Danny R. Ed N. is January 4th. I forgot to write down when is Wits, but Wits is this week. And next Saturday, January 7th, is Art S. And then Barbara A's is on Sunday, and they are both having a significant special birthdays. They're both turning the same year old. So I don't know, Christmas anniversaries? I don't know. I've done some Christmas weddings. You guys? 43 years on the 28th. Blessings on you guys.
So. I
I didn't know your anniversary was this. Oh, okay, so 39 for the Deegans. That's wonderful. I hope you took her out someplace good.
Blessings for my son Ron's birthday, that was yesterday.
See, more for Ron's birthday, so he was a New Year's Eve baby. Wonderful, wonderful. Let us be in a spirit of prayer. Gracious Lord, amazing God, this time of year is filled with so much light and love, and we give thanks for wedding anniversaries and for couples who are newly married this past week, as we pray for everybody who is celebrating birthdays and for babies who are born. We give you thanks for the opportunity to spend time with family and friends and to laugh and to bake and to share gifts with one another. And Lord, we also know that this is also a very challenging time for many. We know how many are seeing that empty seat around the table and are grieving the loss of their loved ones deeply. We pray for those whose losses are recent. We pray for your peace to be upon their hearts. We pray for all those who are walking with their loved ones through hospice, as we pray for those who are walking through medical journeys, whether that be for cancer treatment, whether they're recovering from surgery or from a break, or whether they're anticipating surgery. We pray for all families who are in transition, as well as for those who are in conflict. We pray for those who are housing and food insecure, as well as those who are under and unemployed. And Lord, we continue to lift up those who struggle with addiction, depression, mental illness, PTSD, and chronic diseases. In the silence of our hearts, Lord, we ask your healing prayers to be upon all these people. And we thank you, Lord, for all who so faithfully serve you. We thank you for our active military, our National Guard, our first responders, as well as our medical and teaching staffs. We pray for all who have been separated from their loved ones because they have been serving and loving their neighbors this past holiday season. Lord, in the silence of our hearts, we give you thanks for the blessings of this new day. And Lord, we pray for everyone who feels like they have no one to walk with them, no one to pray for them. We pray that all people might see your face experience your blessings and presence, and know Christ's love in their lives. Lord, guide us that we might make these prayers come true. We pray in the name of Christ's child, our Messiah. Amen. Worship has so many wonderful parts that go on to make sure it feels magical for all those who worship. So I am so thankful for those who help set up for Blue Christmas, for those who help clean up for Blue Christmas, for those who help make the youth musical be such a spiritual and inspiring moment. I'm thankful for the people who fixed the Advent wreath after I broke it. I'm thankful for people who came in and cleaned up Christmas Eve this past week, including the sand that I left in the parking lot because there was a great big ice lake, right? So there's all these little teeny things that go on in a church family, and I'm so very thankful for people who see that these kind of mundane gifts are wonderful gifts that we give in glory to God. And so I invite you, whether with your finances in this new year or with your acts of words or service, to offer up all of your talents to God in glory forevermore.
Thank you.
Dedication. As your faithful have done generation after generation, we too bring our gifts to the Christ child and ask you, amazing God, to bless us and bless our gifts. May our gifts build your community of peace and love for all people. In the name of the Christ child, we pray. Amen. During the communion hymn, I invite you to prepare communion bread and cup.
Thank you.
God came to earth as a little baby to show you the depth and breadth of God's unconditional love. In the spirit of Jesus, who is God's love in human form, I invite you to this table, a community for all. Will you be with me in a spirit of prayer? Holy God, as you bless us with your presence, we ask you to also bless us with this bread and cup. Remind us that you love us so much that you have given your very self out of love for us. Help us be transformed by your love. Help us embody your peace, hope, and joy. In this holy meal, connect us more deeply with you and with others. We pray in the name of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. In the different items we use for communion, we remember that God has created us wonderfully unique. And as we join together in this communion meal, we remember that we are one united body of Christ. Following the words of blessing, the words of consecration, I will invite you to share the bread of life and the cup of the new covenant with me. On the night when Jesus was betrayed, he gathered with his disciples in an upper room, where an ordinary meal became an instrument of God. At this table, Jesus broke bread with those who would betray him. At this table, Jesus drank wine with the one who would deny him. At this table, Jesus communed with those who would abandon him. At this table, Jesus gave a new commandment to love one another as God loves us. At this table, Jesus took the bread and gave thanks to God. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, Jesus took the cup, and after giving thanks to God, he gave it to his disciples and said, "I invite you to drink. This is the cup of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness from our failings and hope for the new life to come. Do this as often as you drink of it, in remembrance of me." I invite you to join me in sharing the bread of life. Please join me in sharing the cup of the new covenant, hope for the new life to come here on earth and in heaven. Thank you, Lord, for coming to us in the simple things in life. Help us to know that you are forever with us, with each bite of bread we take, with each sip we do, with each baby we embrace. Help us know that all of these are signs of your unconditional love for us and the world. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I pray you may be filled with Christ's love and with Christ's peace. And I pray that God's promises of old might fill you with new life and that you may go and be God's blessing to all the world. Go in the peace and love of Jesus Christ. Amen. Happy New Year.